So this is my channel, I'm Kemito Bear, and please don't forget to like, subscribe on the link down below for more videos like this. So let me show you where the video started.
She said I won't be back in a while. Already packed her bags, called the cab, made space, and she said I won't answer.
Hi K-Tribe, welcome back to my YouTube channel. My name is Kemito Bear, and in today's video, it's Vlogmas Day, Nana?
15!
Vlogmas Day 15! 10 more days to Christmas, we've done it. We've done it, guys. So Vlogmas Day 25, I've revealed why I moved out, and also in today's video, it's so emotional, guys. I'm gonna take you to where it all started, to where I first uploaded a video. This is so emotional to me, guys, and I just want to thank you. I'm almost gonna cry. Like, I don't know if I should cry, Diana. Please cry. I should cry, like the real cry, but you guys know you don't do that here. You don't cry, like, I don't know, like when I laugh it's when I'm anxious. So this is why it all started, guys. I was so broke. I'm still broke, but at least broke, basically. What am I saying? But guys, I want to thank you. My top country viewers is from Kenya, guys. I love you, my people from USA, United States, and from United Kingdom. Thank you so much for always watching me. Thank you for sharing my videos, commenting on my videos, for liking my videos. Over 38,000 likes this year, over 1 million views this year, guys. I'm so thankful, and I'm just gonna show you the house where I started all this, guys. I was out, I had just been fired from work, and I was so depressed and anxious, guys. Right now, looking back, I think I was really depressed. Okay, before talking so much, I'm gonna just go show you where it all started. If you like this kind of videos, like, comment, and subscribe. You guys know I don't like sharing emotional videos or too overwhelming videos, but I'm going to be starting to do that more so that you can get to know me. I'm not always smiling. You guys always say I'm always happy, but behind this smile, there's a lot of struggles. Yeah, so let's go and I'll show you the house tour. I just passed it and it's empty, so it's a good opportunity for me to show you guys, and maybe we'll learn more. Okay, let's go.
Because of copying, like cloning.
Right. Now I'm Molly. So Jackson, Molly, where Molly?
If you call me when you're lonely, I guess I'll let her go. Never mind, it's too late. But I can't believe I let you slip. I think about it 7 days a week, and this just can't be how it's supposed to end up. It's not enough. And maybe time will make you feel.
This is why I did the first video. It wasn't my first video, but it was my most viral video, because I did a Nairobi Diaries on it. The bedroom, it was not even my bedroom. It was my sister's bedroom, guys. So I used to do it because this is where the only light was. Can you show them the light? This is only where the light was. And then the one video I did in the bathroom. I'm So this is, I used to do video also here because I only had
lighting.
And
because of the lighting.
Because of the lighting. So we had two places for the lighting. Then this is the kitchen I used to cook videos. This is so emotional for me. This is the kitchen. And you can see the way the sitting room, the living room is dark. So I never used to do that. Come back here. And then guys, I used to sleep on the floor in the living room, guys. I was so depressed, but I was so, like, YouTube really saved my life because when I started doing YouTube videos, I had purpose again. And looking for a job in Kenya, it was so hard, guys. I used to even look for cleaning job, and you have to know someone to know someone. And I'd gotten fired from my first job. I had to move out. So I'm always thankful for my sisters, because my sisters have always supported me and they've always like cheered me. Like, I'm so blessed to have sisters. Even though I was sleeping on the floor, I made things happen. So yeah, so to tell you this.
Diana BTS.
This is not Diana BTS. I'm so happy. Yes, I'm not like looking at this currently and where I am right now. Still, but though I'm not
where you want to be, but at least you are better.
I want to be, but affording a bed sitter on my own with YouTube money, guys, I can't believe it. I can't believe the life I have now. I'm still a broke ass nigga, but broke with affording a bed sitter, and that's achievement to me. And I know where God is taking me, and I'm so thankful. And I want you, when you're watching this video, to always be encouraged. And to know
nothing
that
is impossible.
Nothing is impossible, and always like know every obstacles you're going through with life, there is somewhere you're going through. I'm so happy that right now I can afford my life. I can afford to even take a small trip. Like, I'm so happy, and I do all this because of YouTube and because of you guys. So if you're watching me from everywhere, thank you so much. Continue liking my videos, sharing, commenting. I love replying to comments because I know you always take time to watch my videos. And yeah, I'll keep on telling my story to young youth. If you like, if there is no job opportunities, like in Kenya, there's no job opportunities, don't worry, start anything that you want right now. I used to vlog, I used to video with my Microsoft phone. I'll show you the Microsoft phone. I have it up to now. I can't even throw that phone away. It's dead now, but I used to video with that. And then when I was out of work, I used to, all my savings, I didn't even have one shilling. I used to buy the Canon camera, and the first video I did with it, it went viral, the Nairobi Diaries video. And what I'll encourage people, if you're a YouTuber or you're thinking to be a YouTuber, don't depend on anyone, don't wait on anyone. These people will not work with you right now, but they will work with you when they see potential with you. So if you're starting, concentrate on you, yourself, you and yourself, and people will follow you. Don't think like you need to travel to make it on YouTube, you need to show makeup, or you need to do this. Show your own personality, guys, and you will make it. Me, and try and jump on trending videos that really relate to you. For me, when I was doing Nairobi Diaries, I didn't do Nairobi Diaries to share this women or to do like stuff to this women. Me, I thought it was a reality TV show which was portraying Nairobi girls in a very wrong, like this, like that TV show was only 10%, even 5% of Nairobi girls, because Nairobi girls are hustlers. They are not opportunists, or they are not cocaine addicts. They are not 10%, like Nairobi girls were to go hardcore hustlers who make things work. So if you are a YouTuber or whatever career you want to focus on, know that you yourself alone, you're the only one who will take yourself out of that situation. Okay guys, I wish, okay, that's all I have to say.
She said I won't be back in a while, don't wait. Already packed her bags, called the cab, made space.
This is the only balcony we had. But then why did I not used to do videos? Yeah.
What does it?
Yeah. Yeah. I'm proud of it. And don't worry about haters and trolls calling you that, oh, you're living on a bedsitter, oh, you're living with your sister. All those, take all those negative comments and
be your motivation. Yeah.
Yeah, and motivate yourself. I know God will take me higher and higher, because in this life, I always wish people, even like, I don't have any enemies. To me, I don't have any enemies. I don't have, like, if you think you are my enemy, that's then you're an imaginary. You're imagining you're my enemy. But me, I love everyone. I know people go through struggles, but me, when I was down, I never used to kick others. Even Nairobi Diaries, it was just a scripted show, which I felt it showed a lie. Like, those are just 5% of Nairobi women. Yeah. So let's give a last to one. This is how I used to sleep. I put a mattress here and sleep here. Of course, there was sofa and all that, but you never saw this room because it was really dark. That's all, guys. I think Nana should take a bath here. Yeah, so I used to vlog with this. This is the phone I was telling you. This is what I used to vlog with it. Everywhere I crack side, but I have sentimentals attachment to this. I bought this phone, and then that's when I got fired. That's when I got fired. I bought this phone with my last salary, so I'm always too attached to this phone. But I'm still have it. I can't even sell it. I have to fix the screen. The screen is the only thing that is damaged, but that's not the point. So this is what I used to vlog with. Like, it was had awful quality, but nani kemuto. I didn't care. I was just ready to start. And what I can advise people is just start with whatever phone you have. And imagine, things just happen, because if you don't start, how will you know if you like vlogging? At least start, and then you invest later. Because can you imagine if you're buying a camera and that's all you're saving? Like a quality camera, like a Canon camera, and then maybe you're not interested in vlogs anymore. I've seen many people like just quitting, and they've bought good equipment and they're not even using it. So it's best to start with whatever phone you have. So if you feel like this is what you want to do, then you invest. But if money is not a problem to you, buy the best vlogging camera there. And yes, so another thing is, after that I used to go with this phone. This is a Sony Xperia phone. This one is my sister who got me for my birthday. And was it my birthday or for Christmas? I think it was a Christmas. It was on my wish list, and she bought me this phone. So I used to vlog with this phone. You know, in Nairobi, you can't, because after I finished, like, I decided, what the heck, I like vlogging, let me just buy a Canon EOS 700D. And that thing was so heavy, it cost creation. And the first vlog I did with that Canon, it was the SDR video, and it was so shaky because it was so heavy, so I couldn't carry it everywhere, and it didn't have stabilization, and people, like police, will stop me, and it created unwanted attention, and people say, don't vlog here, don't do this, you need permission. So it created so much attention, unwanted attention, and I didn't use it. So that's when my sister got me this phone, and I used to vlog with this phone until last year when I was out and about in Nairobi streets. I used to vlog with this phone, because if you're in Nairobi, you know, police, Kanjo, city council, they will not let you vlog with your camera, professional camera. And that's why I upgraded this year with an iPhone. Yeah, babe bought me an iPhone. Yeah, so that's why I upgraded, and that's what I'm using right now to flex and be vlogging the streets of Nairobi. So, and you see, I can't even vlog when my sisters are here. We always are chit chatting. But I was so happy, guys. I'm so thankful of where I am right now. I am still not the rich I'm not rich, but I'm not broke as I was 4 years ago, and I'm thankful that you guys watch my video because you are the ones who make me to be here right now. And where all your money goes, guys, like my MacBook Pro, the reason I bought the MacBook Pro, I'm not flossing, by the way, it's because too I can be editing videos fast and put them fast. And why I was able to afford a MacBook Pro is through your donation, guys. So all your PayPal donations, I know people ask, why do you ask people to support you, They support me so that I can keep on creating this content and to put out content fast, because the game on YouTube is the YouTube algorithm like you to be posting videos consistently. Like the least amount of videos you should be posting is 3 videos a week. If you want to grow on YouTube, you need to show up and to show out. You need to be posting video. So that's where your PayPal donations, super chats, M-Pesa goes to the goal to upgrade my gear on YouTube. Currently, I'm saving up for a Rode wireless. I'll put it here. That's on my wish list. I'm saving also for a lens. I'm about to buy the lens. I'm saving for the wide angle lens so that I can be using my camera and I do travel vlogs. Because you need to invest in your equipment so that people like you have good quality. Right now on YouTube, you need to have really good quality, good lighting, good everything, so that you can compete with the best of the best. So yeah, guys, so that's what I'm saving for. If you want to support the channel, follow me on PayPal. I know some people feel itch on that, but do it on your free will. No one is putting a gun on you. And thank you for all those who have been supporting me. You know yourself, thank you so much. I wouldn't be here if it's not for your generous contribution. Thank you so much. I never even used to afford Wi-Fi, guys. Wi-Fi, I never used to afford it, and it was 2,500 Kenyan shillings. I never used to afford it. It was a hassle to get it, but I would save every penny, because it's like saving 50 bob every day. And guys, getting 50 bob when you don't have so source of income is really tough. So that's what I did. I babysitted also. That's how I did. Okay, guys, watch those. I'll put the vlogs here. I'll put the videos here so that you can see my journey and the house I did. I did my first video on. Okay, guys. Bye.